Welcome back to Decode's Rapid Developer tutorial. From last video, we have seen how to create message print and custom message box in Frappe framework. In this video, we will discuss how to set a value to a doc field using script. So let's start learning. Let's open the web application. Click on add parent doc. And here I am going to show you how to set up the full name using first name and last name. For that, let's open the parent doc.js file. And the method used for set a value on a doc field is form.setValue. In bracket, we have to mention the name of the field and the value. So here I'm going to set the full name field. That field name is full name. Here I am set the full name using the first name and last name. So to access the first name, we can use form dot doc dot then field name, which is first name, then plus leave one space, then again plus. Now I am fetching the data from last name, form dot doc dot last name. Sorry, last underscore name. So let's create validate event and just cut this function and paste it inside this validate event. Let's save this and check whether it is working or not. I'm going to open my parent doc type and refresh it. Create a new parent document. Let's give the name a new John. Let's save this. And now we can see the full name Anu John in full name doc field. So our set value function is working. Now I am going to create a dialog box in Frappe and then I fetch the values from dialog box and set the value to some doc fields. So for creating a dialog box, we can follow this step. And give a title. I'm going to give the title name enter the parent details. And now we can create different fields inside the dialog box. So here I am going to create three fields and the fields are first name, last name and age. So let's create the fields. Let's give a label and label is first name, then the field name. I am going to give the field name first name. Mention the field type. So I am selecting data field. Let's copy this and paste it inside this fields. So let's arrange this and put a comma after each field. So let's change to last name and also field name last name. Here I'm entering age. So now we successfully created our doc type fields. Next I am going to assign an action. It's a primary action. So let's give a primary action label and the label is submit. Now we can define a primary action. Let's fetch the values. Here I'm going to fetch the values from this dialog box and I'm going to set that values into my parent doc. So for that, let's define a primary action. Setting values we can use this set value method. So let's copy this and paste it inside. Three times goes, we are setting three values. So first I'm going to set the first name, and next I'm going to set the last name, and lastly the age. So let's change the field names. My first field name is first name. We can fetch the values from dialog box using values dot then the field name. Let's enter the field name, first name, and second field is last name. I'm going to fetch the last name from dialog box. Last underscore name and the age. Values dot age. So these are my primary action, and here I'm going to hide my dialog box after primary action. So for that, let's use this method d.hide, and for showing this dialog box, let's add one more method, and which is d.show. Now everything is set, and let's call this method on refresh event. So before that, let's comment this. And create a refresh event and paste all these codes into that refresh event. So let's cut this and paste it inside refresh event. So now everything is fine, and let's save this. Go to my parent doc type. Let's refresh this. And create a new parent doc type. So now we can see our dialog box, and I think we have some error because the title is not shown in this message box, and also submit button is not there. So let's check. We can see some spelling mistake in my code. So let's correct this. So here I'm going to add one more method, and which is an is new method, because I'm going to show this dialog box when the form is new. Let's add this method. It should be inside an if statement. Let's cut this and paste it inside this if condition. So here we have one spelling mistake again, which is FIREST. So let's save this and refresh the parent document again. Create a new parent document. Let's give the name Bijoy Anil and age is 22. So let's click on submit. And now we can see the first name, last name and age in our new parent document. So let's save this. And we successfully saved our document. And here we can see the document name is changed to Bijoy. So this is how we can create dialog box in Frappe framework, and we can also set values from dialog box to our parent document. Next, I will show you one more inbuilt method used in Frappe, and which is isDirectory. So this method is used for identifying the document is saved or not. So the method is form.isDirectory, and this method will return true when the form is not saved, and it will return false when the form is saved. Let's check this method using an if condition. Now I am going to call a message print method. Let's print the message. Please save the document. Now I am going to comment this dialog box. And let's trigger this method using a doc field event, and doc field is enabled. Paste this inside this enable trigger. So let's save this. Go to parent document, refresh it, and create a new parent document. Here we can see the enable checkbox. Let's click on that. So it will trigger the message, please save this document, because the form is not saved yet. So here we can see the status, it is not saved. From this video, we have seen how to set up a value to a doc field using script and also using message box. And we also discuss the isDate method used for checking whether the document is saved or not. So let's wind up this video and see you on the next video. Bye.